Image and brand consultant Natalie Weekly is joining us to put our knowledge to the test. And folks, don't forget, you can play along with us at clicktovote.com. Natalie, welcome back to the show.
Thank you guys for having me.
We can't wait for this. I hope we don't fail miserably.
I think you'll make it.
Okay.
But it'll be good. It'll be good reminders.
So you're going to quiz us. You're going to ask us questions,
yes,
and then we have to ring in.
It's going to be great.
Okay.
Okay, you guys
started.
Ready? Yes. Okay, so parties can sometimes make people nervous, whether you're introvert, extrovert. What's the best way to prep for great conversation? You can read the headlines. You can have two or three back pocket questions at the ready. You can do a mental review of names and faces of those who might be there, or you can wear a controversial graphic tee.
Oh.
Oh, the graphic tee.
I would say review the headlines to spice it up. Courtney, wear the graphic tee.
Well, I mean, like, what party am I going to?
Because,
like,
so
sometimes you don't want to be reading the headlines at something that it's just inappropriate to talk about at that party.
You're absolutely right. You do need to consider where you're going. I would say those top three are all great. If you want to review the headlines, it gives you some good talking points. Hey, did you know that they successfully launched a SpaceX rocket this weekend? Isn't that cool? You could talk about that. But the one of the things that helps the most is having two or three back pocket questions. And that is maybe, where are you from originally? Since like four people are from Houston originally.
Right.
And so that can spark conversation. Also, is there a good book that you've read recently? Or how did you get involved in this cause or hear about this event or whatever it is?
Okay, that's good advice.
Yeah.
Or just be an interesting person, right? If you take selfies all day, you might not have much to talk about.
Maybe probably not.
Maybe no. Okay, so you have walked into the party. When is the best time to approach someone at a party? When they walk in the door, when they're in line to get a drink, after they visited the food and drink station, or I'm an introvert, I don't talk to people.
In line for a drink?
If it's Courtney, don't approach her. That wasn't a joke.
It's totally true.
I don't know, in line at the bar?
In line at the bar.
It's awkward if they have food
in there. Because we're all waiting there anyway.
Right. Yeah. Okay, so we were talking about this over the weekend as well. There are a couple things. So right when you walk into an event, think about, you're trying to scope out the scene. You're trying to figure out what's going on.
You're trying to find the bar.
You're trying to find the bar. You're trying to find the welcome desk. You're trying to find whatever it is. So if you want to approach someone, then just say, hey, we're glad you're here. Here's where you're going to sign in. Here's the refreshment table. So that, like, we're not going to have a great, meaningful conversation.
We're going to get you on your way.
Yes. And you're going to be thinking, well, I don't want to be stuck with you yet because I don't even know who's here yet. So, yes, when they're in line is good, but it's still a little bit of a kind of stuck situation. And it's going to end as soon as they get their drink, possibly. So the best time is after they've already visited the refreshment station, whether it's drinks or food or whatever, so that they are ready. It's like after you walk into a cafeteria in high school or middle school and you're like, who do I talk to? That's a great time to then talk to somebody, because that's when they're most feeling like, I really want to talk to somebody right now.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. So, introductions. Which of these elements of an introduction makes starting a conversation as smooth as possible? Names. How you know each other. A tidbit about the person. Their political views. Or almost all of them.
Oh, dear.
Oh, I would say not the political view. I mean, how you know the person, I would think would be, you know, because that's, if you're going to a wedding and you don't know a lot of people, are you, you know, do you know the bride, do you know the groom? Like, what do you, you know?
Absolutely. That is a fantastic piece to include. I would say almost all of the above. Of course, you want to include names. So if I, and how you know each other. So if I'm introducing Derek, this is my friend Courtney. We know each other from TV.
We used to work in the Galleria together.
We used to work in the Galleria together. It's so true. And I know you guys are both come from distant lands to come here in Houston. I'm sure you can compare notes on how Houston is wildly different from Chicago and LA. And then that gives you guys, so I've told you how I know you and how, so you can start talking there. And I've also given you a tidbit about the other person so you can start the conversation. Because the worst is where you're like, hey, Derek, Courtney, Derek, Courtney, Derek. And then you're like,
hi.
What do I do? Great. And then
Or even worse than that is when people don't introduce other people. I see it all the time socially.
It happens all the time.
People walk up and like, am I invisible? And eventually I put my hand out and I say, hi, I'm Derek.
Yeah.
Sorry your rude friend didn't introduce you, but I'll do that job.
Which also means
seriously,
that
it's one of my pet peeves.
Well, means you're also thinking about that instead of listening to whatever's happening, because you're like, well, I want this person to feel oriented. I want to feel oriented, because again, that's where good connection happens, when we all know what's going
on
and how, why we're there.
Yes,
exactly.
Good.
Feels great. Okay, so conversation. What's the best way to step up your conversation game? Obviously, if you're at a social event, there's a lot of talking. So one, talk the entire time. Who's more interesting than me?
Yes.
ask how are you, or keep things straightforward, just ask yes or no questions, or go big. Switch this weather is crazy, huh, to what's the most extreme weather you've been in.
Oh, I like that. The last one.
Yeah, going big is the best because we all have, man, can you believe how cold it is? And yeah, it is really cold. Or can you believe how crazy this weather is? Yes, it is crazy. It's literally bipolar. And you could talk about that, or you can say, what's the most extreme weather you've been in?
Well, then you're also getting to know that person.
Exactly.
So you're putting a little bit of investment into it, even
yes.
though, I mean, it's just nice. It's sometimes people don't get asked questions, you
right.
know? They're that worst feeling is like when somebody's on their phone and talking to you, but they're not listening.
Right.
So, you know, when you ask those questions, that other person
kinda
feels
stops
important.
For a second, yes. It makes the conversation flow
or
so much more
Or just make up a really exciting story.
Or you could also do that if you're an impromptu kind of person. Okay, so we've greeted, we've talked. Now we're gonna go sit down at the table, especially if you're at a big gala or something like that, especially if it's a round table. So what side of the, we're gonna do one quick etiquette question. What side of the place setting does your bread go? Does it go on the left or does it go on the right?
Doesn't it go top right? Am I totally wrong? Is it top left?
Yeah, top right is your water glass, right?
And your three wine glasses.
Yeah, I think it's left.
It is left.
Is it
yeah.
left?
Here's the best trick to remember. Go like this.
Oh, it's a B for bread.
Exactly. Yeah. Bread, drink.
Yeah.
Mind
for
blown.
Bread.
Mind
bread,
blown.
Drink. Yep.
You will never forget again, and you will never be the guy who steals someone else's water glass and then have to have the awkward conversation.
Right.
Unless
oh, that's
your way
tip.
Of starting
I'll be at the table doing
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
You can do it underneath the table so no one has to know what's happening. Okay, so you've had a great conversation, you've had dinner, and now you're gonna leave the conversation. So what's the best way to leave a conversation? Because sometimes
don't ask Courtney.
You need to leave a conversation. One, you probably wanna talk to other people here. Or I wanna talk with a few others while I'm here, I've enjoyed talking to you. Or I don't wanna take up all your time. Or does ghosting work for one-on-one conversations?
Courtney would be like, hey, Natalie.
Oh, is that you?
Not true, not true. I do see an exit. I do ghost, but I do it when it makes sense, but I don't want to take up your time, all of your time. I've said that before. I
yes.
know you want to, you know, right. mingle with others.
So your absolute best is to say, I've enjoyed talking with you. I want to make sure that I have a chance to talk with some other people. Or I want to make, oh, I just saw Derek. I haven't had a chance to talk with him yet. I'm going to go say hello.
It was an interesting conversation, but it wasn't that interesting.
Well, gotta go.
So we talked about that some people felt that it was a bit more direct, that it's like,
yeah.
I'm done talking to you. But honesty is always good. But if you're saying, I don't want to take up all your time, or I know you want to talk to somebody else here, you can say, actually, I really don't know anyone else here. I'm so glad to let this conversation keep going.
Yeah, and you're like,
and then
you're
I'm like,
stuck.
No, no, I yeah. really am done with this conversation.
Okay.
So it's so much better if you can frame it as what you want to do versus what they want to do.
Okay, Natalie Weekly,
way.
We got to leave it there.
Okay.
Thanks so much for stopping by.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah,
I appreciate it.